In this video, we will see that how we can insert a table in Microsoft Word, enter data in the table, format the table, giving styles to the table, and convert the table into text. So let's get started. Let's start from inserting a table in Microsoft Word. We want to insert a table between these two paragraphs. So I will click here and press Enter key. Now you can see that this is the place where we want to insert a table. There are multiple ways to insert a table. To insert a table, we have to go here in Insert tab and have to expand the table option. We can insert a table by just selecting rows and columns. Here you can see that I have selected two columns and one row. Now three columns and one row, four columns and one row. Now here you can see that I have selected four columns and four rows. Now four columns and five rows. I will just click and the table will be inserted. The second method to insert a table by just clicking here on Insert table, and here we have to specify the number of rows and columns. So I want four columns and five rows. After this, I just have to click OK and the table will be inserted. Before formatting, let's add some data in this table. So we have entered all the data. Now let's set the table. If you want to select the entire table at once, then you just have to click here and the entire table will be selected. If you want to resize the table, then you can do from here. Here you can see that I am resizing the table. You can increase and decrease the size of these columns by using ruler. If you are not able to see this ruler in Microsoft Word, then you have to come here in View tab and have to check this box with name ruler, and the ruler will be appeared on your screen. Now let's change the size of these columns by using ruler. For example, I want to maintain the equal size of these three columns, and I want to make this column little bit bigger. So how I can do this? I will just move my cursor here. When cursor shape will be changed, I will just drag on the right side. Now I will drag it at 3 and I will drag it at 4. Now increase the size. This is at 2, 3, 4 and this should be at 5. So you can see that how I have adjusted the size of these columns. Now let's align the text. So to align the entire text of this table at once, you just have to select the entire data of this table. Selecting the entire table is something else, and selecting the entire data in this table is something else. If you want to select the entire table, you just have to click here. And if you want to select the entire data, you just have to use your mouse cursor. Now we will go here in Home tab and we will format this data. For example, we will align this data at center. We can increase and decrease the size of this data. We can change the font style. We can bold this data, italic and underline this data. We can use all options in font, paragraph and styles group for this data. In this table, to move left to right, you just have to press tab key from your keyboard. For moving upward and downward, you can use arrow keys. And the one thing which is to be noted is that when you have inserted a table in Microsoft Word, these two new tabs will be introduced. The first one is table design and the second one is layout. When you will click anywhere outside the table, these two tabs will be disappeared. If you want to appear them again on the ribbon, you have to click anywhere inside the table and these tabs will be appeared again. Now if you want to add some styles to the table, you have to select the entire table. So selecting the entire table, we have to click here. The entire table has been selected. Now here you can see three tabs. The first one is table design, layout and equation. For changing the style, we have to go here in table design, and here we can find different styles for this table. You can select any one of them. When you will select a design, here you can see the design have been implemented on the table. Now we'll click here. Again, go in table design and here you will find some table styles options. Here you can see that the first row is now a header row and the first column is the main column of this table. If you don't want to add the header row, you just have to uncheck this box and the header row will be disappeared. If you don't want the banded rows, you have to uncheck this box and the banded rows will be disappeared. We can also add additional rows and columns in this table. To add an additional row, we have to move our cursor here, and here you will find a plus sign. If you want to add a row here between these two rows, again you will see a plus sign. You just have to click on this plus sign and an additional row will be added. If you want to add an additional column, you just have to come here and you will find here a plus sign. You just have to click here and additional column will be added in this table. So in this way, you can add extra or additional rows and columns in the existing table. Now let's see that how we can convert this table into text. I have already told you that this ruler has an important role in making tables. So let's see that how we can convert this table into text. For converting this table into text, we have to come here in Layout tab, and here you will find an option Convert to Text. Here you can see that the text will be separated with tabs. Here these are tabs that we have created when we inserted the table. Now we'll just click OK. Here you can see that the table has converted into text. So this was all about formatting the table in Microsoft Word. If you really enjoyed the video, please support us and subscribe our YouTube channel. And don't forget to like this video. Thank you.